Neurocardiogenic syncope is the most common cause of syncope. Initial measures in management include lifestyle modifications, increasing the fluid and salt intake, and education about physical counterpressure methods. Pharmacological measures may be tried next. Pacemaker implantation has been tried in those with predominantly cardio-inhibitory syncope. Physical counterpressure measures are movements like leg crossing and hand gripping, which may prevent loss of consciousness in those who feel the presyncopal symptoms. These measures increase the systemic vascular resistance and blood pressure to counter the vasodepressive element of neurocardiogenic syncope. An important limitation of physical counterpressure measures is that they can be applied by only those who have prodromal symptoms. Important pharmacological agents which have been tried in the management of neurocardiogenic syncope are midodrine, beta blockers, paroxetine, and fludrocortisone. Midodrine has been given a class 2 recommendation in the management of neurocardiogenic syncope. Beta blockers may have some benefit in those above 40 years and has been given a class 2B recommendation, but it may be harmful in those below 42 years, as noted in an analysis of the randomized prevention of syncope trial which used metoprolol. POST 5 is evaluating the role of metoprolol in those aged 40 years or more. It is a multi-center international randomized placebo-controlled trial. Implantation of a cardiac pacemaker is considered in those with a predominantly cardio-inhibitory response. Pacemaker is reserved for those with a severely reduced quality of life due to frequent syncope, which is refractory to lifestyle changes, physical measures, and medications. Pacing is planned for refractory cases above 40 years with pause more than 6 seconds with a class 2B recommendation. Closed-loop stimulation is thought to be better than rate drop algorithm. Spain study has shown that dual-chamber pacing with closed-loop stimulation improves quality of life and syncope burden in patients 40 years or more with 5 or more episodes of vasovagal syncope and cardio-inhibitory response induced by head-up tilt testing. Cardiac vagal innervation is through ganglia in the atrial wall and epicardial fats. Ablation of these ganglia may also be associated with destruction of sympathetic nerve endings. But as the sympathetic ganglia situated in the sympathetic trunk are not destroyed, these nerve endings can grow back. Thus, ablation of the parasympathetic ganglia may be useful in preventing the bradycardic response in neurocardiogenic syncope. Spectral mapping and high-frequency stimulation in areas known to have ganglionic plexi can be used to determine sites of radiofrequency catheter ablation. Multiple small-scale studies have shown benefit. Randomized controlled clinical trials are needed to evaluate this aspect further. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.